Sometimes older people will be worried and ask me, you know, I forgot where my keys are. Is that Alzheimer's disease? I forget where my keys are all the time, and I've done it since I was in my 20s. If you forget where your keys are, that sort of forgetting is a part of normal aging. If you have somebody with dementia and you put the keys in their hand, they won't know what the keys are called, and they won't know what they're for. So there's a big difference between normal forgetfulness and dementia. Dementia is the most common mental illness in later life. I get a lot of questions about dementia. Probably the most common question is, what's the difference between dementia and Alzheimer's disease? Alzheimer's disease is one kind of dementia. It's the most prevalent kind. Between 50 to 70% of all dementias can be attributed to Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is characterized by changes in memory, and such changes are what most people associate with dementia. Dementia is the umbrella category for a whole range of progressive neurological illnesses that are characterized by changes in thinking and personality and behavior. So, dementia is not just one symptom, and different people can manifest different symptoms. It involves intellectual impairment, usually memory, but also language and executive functions, such as goal setting, can be affected. A good definition of dementia is that it is an acquired syndrome of intellectual impairment produced by brain dysfunction. We know dementia mostly affects people over 65, although you can get early onset dementia in your 30s and 40s. That usually occurs in families where there's a strong genetic heritability. In most forms of dementia, there is some degree of heritability. But for most dementias, in most people, the genetic influence on risk is relatively small. It is nowhere near, for example, the fact that smoking doubles your risk of dementia. Lifestyle risk factors can be much more influential than your genes. The prevalence for dementia is about 6 to 7% in most developed countries. Dementia is not part of primary aging. All dementias stem from a disease process. This slice of brain on the slide illustrates this. On the left side is a brain of a 70-year-old with Alzheimer's disease. On the right side is a normal, healthy 70-year-old brain. You can see a big difference in the disease process versus normal aging. It's very clear. Now, early dementia signs can be subtle, but they usually quickly develop into something that is categorically not normal. This is how it plays out. Sometimes you forget a name or an appointment. That's normal aging. If you increasingly cannot remember things, even when people remind you or give you hints, that is more likely to be dementia. This abnormal change is because what is being processed within the brain is no longer reliably stored in the brain due to cellular changes in the brain resulting from the disease process. We sometimes have trouble finding a word for something. That's normal aging. If you forget the names of very common things, if you forget the names of close relatives, that's more likely to be dementia. If you're a little bit more irritable when somebody makes you the wrong kind of coffee in a cafe, that's probably normal aging. You get used to certain things, and you've gone to that same cafe, ordering the same coffee, and, well, you want your coffee the way you like it. You did not order that latte, so you get a little irritated. People with dementia have really big changes in personality. Somebody who is an introvert becomes very extroverted, or the reverse. It's a very stark change. Usually, with normal aging, familiar tasks remain quite robust. If you have a favorite recipe, and you cook that all the time, and you're known for it, normal aging isn't going to affect that. If you have dementia, you'll start forgetting ingredients, forgetting the steps, even though you've done it thousands of times. There's a real clear difference there. Often, when older adults present at their GP or primary care physician, they may complain of decreased memory. It might be that they are worried about dementia, but are really only experiencing slower recall of memories, a primary aging change. Unfortunately, health professionals often leap to the conclusion that dementia is the cause for many kinds of cognitive changes associated with primary aging. Mild forgetting and slower speed of thinking are a normal part of aging, which do not interfere with everyday life significantly, though they are annoying. But dementia is qualitatively different, as is the motor speed loss associated with a disease like Parkinson's disease. And just as in early life, both depression and anxiety are associated with changes in memory. But if older adults are diagnosed, actually I might say labeled, with dementia, when this is not what they are experiencing, then it robs them of the chance to get the proper treatment. It also means that older adults do not receive advice on healthy lifestyle changes, such as quitting smoking or taking up exercise, that can decrease their risk for a range of illnesses, including dementia. That's why these ideas about primary and secondary aging are important. All people, including health professionals, should understand what is expected later in life and what may have to be adapted to, and what is possibly due to an illness or condition that can be treated or possibly even prevented.